Are dogs really man's best friend? In the coming weeks, me and my two dogs, Meg and Hinny, are going to travel around visiting famous landmarks in the north to test man's relationship with his pets and to see if they really are our best friends. Collars on, coats on, pram in, dogs in, let's go. Okay, we're off on the first adventure. Meg's settled in the back and Hinny is stood up still, but hopefully, she likes to watch the first bit of the journey, but hopefully she'll settle down. If not, she'll be squeaking in my ear for the next half an hour. Right, we're nearly there. Hinny's up and ready. So here we are, Crosby Beach, home to Anthony Gormley's Another Place. With views of the Wirral and North Wales, this is truly a spectacular beach.
The beach was also the winner of the Best Coast 2011.
Hinny had a great time chasing the ball and trying to get her coat off, even if the statues did confuse her a little bit. And with 100 statues dotted around the beach, there were plenty to confuse her. We then tried a shortcut to get back to the flatter sand, and that went horribly wrong. We then headed back to the car for an ice cream and a drink for the dogs. Right, today we're off to Liverpool to see the Liver building. We arrived in Liverpool to amazing blue skies. The dogs had been brilliant the whole journey, and as we arrived, they were ready to explore. We began by walking past the historic Liverpool docks and made our way to the front, where we could see the Liver building. The Liver building was completed on the 19th of July 1911 and has two clock towers. At the top of each of these towers is the Liver bird. There is a popular legend that says one faces the city to look after the people and the other looks out to sea at the sailors coming into the port. Another version is that one male is looking inland to see if there are any pubs open and the other is female looking out to see if there are any handsome sailors.
Maybe down in love sometime. we're off to Blackpool today to see the Blackpool Tower. Maybe get some fish and chips if we're lucky.
Blackpool Tower is 518 feet and 9 inches high and is a Grade 1 listed building. We played on the beach for a good hour, and Meg even had enough energy to get out and play.
Hey, fetch! Get it! Grab it, help me. Ready, Hin? Ready? Ready, Hinny? Ready, Hinny? Oh! Ready, Hin? Ready? Come on, then!
Hinny then ruined a little girl's drawing in the sand, which looked very deliberate and an argument against dogs being man's best friend, perhaps.
Sorry.
So then we headed up the street to find some fish and chips, and Meg got a lot of attention. Meg got her fish and chips. They love fish from their old owner, who used to give them canned pilchards. And that leads me on to the story of how I got them. I took on Meg and Hinny in 2012 when their owner passed away. I had been walking them for a year before that, as their owner was having treatment. He always used to laugh about how Meg used to look at me so lovingly and how jealous he was. The day in Blackpool was actually surprisingly enjoyable, and I'm sure Meg and Hinny would love to go again. The journey to Bedgillet started in chaos, as Meg lost control of her bowels halfway into the 2-hour drive. And then to make matters worse, before we could clear it, Hinny decided to rest her neck on the fresh poo, which made it a nightmare to clean up. We then arrived in North Wales and it was hot, very hot. Meg had a little bit of a walk to begin with, but she was really struggling, so after a little walk, we popped her in her pram. The walk to Gellert's grave is very picturesque. You walk along the river and up to the grave, with the mountains watching over you.
Here we are in Bedgalet, in Snowdonia National Park, Wales, to visit the grave of Gelert.
The story of Gelert is an old Welsh tale about a dog whose name was Gelert. His owner had a young child and left him with Gelert while he went out hunting. When he returned, he discovered Gelert covered in blood. He went to his child's cot only to find it empty, and he jumped to the conclusion that Gelert had eaten his son. So he took his sword and killed Gelert. In Gellert's dying yelps, the owner heard his child cry, only to find him alive and well next to a giant wolf Gellert had slain protecting him. The owner was distraught and was said to have never smiled again.
So today we're off to Congleton to see the statue of Trio, the sniffer dog.
This was a trip I was looking forward to, as I had been reading a book about Trio and his handler, Dave. It's a true story about a man and his best friend working together in blistering hot temperatures and saving lives in the process. This earned Trio a Dickin medal, which is the animal equivalent of the Victoria Cross. Sadly, Trio passed away in 2015, but to honour his tremendous skill and bravery, a statue was created for him and placed by the community gardens in Congleton. The book really inspired the trip and led me to wanting to do more with my dogs, as the bond Dave and Trio had was incredible. They were true friends, Dave even considered them family, and that's a very strong argument for dogs being man's best friend. While travelling around over the last few weeks, I have noticed how dogs, more than any other animal, sharing moments with us socially and individually. While we were out on the trip, the amount of people we met and the social barriers and anxieties that someone might usually have can be broken down by a dog, especially when your dog's in a pram. And the individual aspect is when you're at home alone, they are there to comfort you or entertain you. There is never a dull moment when there is a dog around, and that is why they are man's best friend.